education. So I hope everyone can hear me. As we said in the last lecture, let me just briefly recap what we did. In the last lecture, we discussed these various 3G and 4G wireless standards. We introduced different 2G. We started with the 2G standards, that is GSM, CDMA, GPRS, etc. Then we have various 3G standards such as CDMA 2000 and UMTS or WCDMA. And of course, we also have HSDPA HSUPA and so on. And of course, we also talked about the 4G standards such as LTE and WiMAX, that is LTE and WiMAX standard. Alright, so everyone can hear me? I hope everyone can hear me. Fine, so let us go to, and we also talked a little bit about briefly about wireless communications. Let me go to some college trying to write, see if they can remember what we talked about, the different aspects of wireless communications. PSG College of Technology, you can hear me, right? We talked about wireless communications. Do you remember what we talked about wireless communication? What is the defining aspect of wireless communication? Does anyone remember? Does anyone remember what we talked about in wireless communications? What is the defining aspect? What is the difference about wireless communications? What is different in wireless communications compared to wired communication or compared to conventional communication? We talked about multipath propagation, correct? That is multipath propagation. Can you briefly explain what it means, multipath propagation? What is that? Can you repeat it again a bit louder, please?
Sir, the signal transmitting the fixed multiple paths to the receiver.
So different signals, because of the different delays, we have different signals. These signals interfere, and this interference causes fading, right? So that's what I said. Let me just briefly recap what we said. That is what we said last time. That is correct. What we said is basically that these different signals, they arrive at the receiver. So let's say I have a base station. Everyone can see, hopefully everyone can see what I am doing. And if we have a base station and I have a mobile, and then therefore there is a direct path, there is also several scattered paths that come from the scatterers. Which are scatterers are objects such as trees and buildings in the path of propagation. So therefore, because of this scattered paths, what we have is we have multiple signal copies, multiple copies of the same electromagnetic signal. These superimpose at the receiver. When they superimpose at the receiver, what we have is we have interference. And because of this interference, the interference can be either constructive or interference can be destructive. So interference So let me write it. Multipath propagation This multipath propagation leads to interference. The interference can be either constructive or destructive. If it's constructive, it amplifies the signal. If it's destructive, it attenuates the signal. Therefore, we have a varying level of signal at the receiver. This is known as fading. This is known as this multipath fading. This is also known as small scale fading. In general, this is termed as fading. This varying signal level because of interference, this leads to a varying signal level, which is also known as, this is known as fading. Fading is nothing but a variation in the signal level that is arising because of the interference resulting from the multipath propagation. So there are seem to be some technical issues which are getting resolved. Meanwhile, let me go on with today's lecture. Let me start today's lecture. Okay, so in today's lecture, what I want to do is I want to start with a brief mathematical modeling. I want to start with the mathematical modeling of wireless communication systems. So we'll talk about how to model the fading wireless channel and then proceed on to how to characterize the performance across fading wireless channels. Alright, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to start with the mathematical modeling of wireless communication systems. So we'll start with the mathematical modeling. Let me just try to go to someone, try to see if someone can guide me. VPCOE, are you able to hear me? Yeah, it looks like VPC. TKMKTL, which college is this again? TKMKL?
Yes, sir. Good morning, sir.
Good morning. Which college is this?
TKM College Kollam.
Okay, you were able to hear me, right? Now I'm going to start with the mathematical modeling of the wireless communication system. What I want to do is I want to develop an LTE, linear time invariant. Everyone is familiar with LTE, LTI systems, linear time invariant systems, model of a linear time invariant systems. Is everyone familiar with LTI systems? Yeah. Properties of LTI systems? Are everyone familiar with it? Sorry, I cannot hear what people are saying. Okay, alright. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to try to ask some questions and see if someone can respond. Now what I'm going to see, if I have a signal XT, right? And I am transmitting XT and I receive the signal XT with a delay tau naught, right? If I receive the signal with a delay tau naught, can someone tell me what is the model for the LTI system? That is, I am sending a signal XT through a system and I am receiving X of P minus tau naught. Can someone tell me what is the impulse response of such an LTI system? What is the impulse response of this LTI system? So this is input XT.
Delta of P minus tau naught.
What is that?
Delta of T minus tau naught.
So such a system HT has an impulse response which is delta of
T minus tau naught.
Which is delta of T minus tau naught. Very good, very good. That is the impulse response of the system. Now in addition to X of T minus tau naught, if I have an attenuation A naught, can you tell me now what is the impulse response of the system? If also in addition to the delta delay tau naught, I have attenuation, that is A naught, what is the impulse response of the system?
A naught tau T minus
A naught delta T minus tau naught. Thank you very much TKM College. Yeah, so everyone can hear me. So basically what we are saying is, let's say I am transmitting a wireless signal, and if I am transmitting a wireless signal and I am receiving a single path corresponding to delay tau naught and attenuation A naught, then the impulse response of the system is A naught delta T minus tau naught. Let me just go to some others, try to see if they can understand what I am saying. V cap, are you able to follow what I am saying? You are able to hear what I am saying? Are you able to follow what I am saying? You are able to follow what I am saying, right? Okay. So what I am saying is, if there is a single path, if there is a single signal that is received at delay tau naught and attenuation A naught, then the system model is A naught X of T minus tau naught, and therefore the LTI system model is A naught delta T minus tau naught. Now let us say there is another path, and this another path corresponds to attenuation A1 and delay tau1. So the attenuation is A1 and delay is tau1. Can someone tell me what is the impulse response corresponding to, what is the impulse response of the system corresponding to this? So now I am receiving another signal copy with attenuation A1 and delay tau1. What is the impulse response corresponding to this? Can someone tell me? VCAP, can someone tell me? Okay, very good, thank you. So that is A1 delta of T minus tau1. Therefore now let us say we have, in general we have L components. So we are saying this multipath signal propagation. Now in multipath signal propagation, the different signal copies are received with different attenuation and different delay. Let me just try to interact with a different teacher, different college here, try to see if they are able to follow me. So let me go to UIET. Earlier I could not interact with them. Let me see if they are able to hear me. UIET, are you able to hear me and see me? Are you able to follow the discussion so far? Hello, UIET? UIET, are you able to follow me? They have some signal, looks like they have some signal from now. Let me go to RVC. RVC has no video. PCUT, let's go to PCUT. PECUT, are you able to follow what I am saying? PECUT, Punjab Engineering College of Technology. PECUT, are you able to follow me? I cannot see you.
Hello. Hello, yes sir.
You are able to follow what we are saying? That is, if I have a signal that is received corresponding to amplification A naught and delay tau naught, then the signal impulse, the impulse response is A naught del t minus tau naught, right? Everyone is able to follow me?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now what we are going to do is, let's say I have generalized it to L minus 1 components, because I have L minus 1 multipath propagation components. I have the signals corresponding to the first path, let's say attenuation A naught, delay tau naught, attenuation A1, delay tau 1, so on until attenuation A L minus 1, delay tau L minus 1. Is it clear? Are you able to hear what I am saying? Therefore, what is the impulse response corresponding to first path? That is A naught delta t minus tau naught. What is the impulse response corresponding to the second path? Can someone repeat what is that? Corresponding to attenuation A1 and delay tau 1, what is the impulse response corresponding to the second path?
A1.
A1
delta t minus z1.
T minus, okay, that's, it is tau, that is fine. Okay, thank you, I got the idea. And therefore, corresponding to the last one, it is A L minus 1 delta t minus tau L minus 1. Now, therefore, what I am receiving at the receiver is the sum of all the multipath components, right? Because I am receiving different paths, each with a different attenuation and different delay. Therefore, what I am receiving at the receiver is the sum of all the multipath components. Therefore, can you tell me now what is the net system model of the wireless communication system? Can someone tell me, if I am receiving the sum of all the multipath components, what is the impulse response of the net system model? What is the It's up until Punjab Engineering College. What is the net impulse response of the system model?
We will probably add all these.
We will add all the impulse responses, because the sum of the, at the receiver we have the sum of all the received signals. Let me just try to go to other different college. Thank you. That is the correct answer. Yes. Let me try to go to a different college and try to see what is the, if they are able to follow me. RVIT, are you able to hear me?
Yes, sir.
Are you able to follow what I am saying? What my discussion is? What is the net impulse response?
Yes, sir. I am following.
What is, so what is the net? So the net impulse response, so the net impulse response is basically, are there any students there?
Only one student is there. Today fog is so dense and
Fine. Let me try to see if someone else can, if I can interact with someone else. College fees, Reji, Ghaziabad. GIT, are you able to hear me? I think the bandwidth is off. Yes, they were there earlier. BTKIT, are you able to hear me? Vivin Tripathi.
Yes, sir. Good morning.
Good morning. Are you able to hear me? Are you able to follow what I am saying in terms of the net impulse response?
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. So therefore, the net impulse response is basically.
Yes, sir. It will be the summation of all the attenuations and the delays.
And it will be the
possibly sigma considering I as the variable, it will be from 0 to L minus 1. Then Ai of Ai delta t minus tau of I.
Okay, thank you. So I equals 0 to L minus 1 Ai delta t
minus tau I.
Delta t minus tau I, fine. Okay, very good. Thank you. So that is the net impulse response of the system. What is the net impulse response of the system? I hope everyone can hear me. The net impulse response of the system, because we are saying it corresponds to multipath propagation system where we have different multipath signal components. Each multipath signal component is arriving with attenuation Ai and delay tau I. Therefore, what we receive at the receiver, that is the signal we receive at the receiver, is basically the sum of all these multipath components corresponding to different delays and attenuation. Therefore, it is a sum. The impulse response is summation Ai delta t minus tau I. Alright, it is clear. And therefore, what we have is, if I am transmitting a signal ST, ST is the transmitted signal. This is, let's say, the transmitted signal. This is, let's say, the transmitted signal. Therefore, what is the output signal? Yt. Yt is, Vipin Tripathi College, can someone tell me, Yt is St convolved with St convolved with Ht. St convolved with Ht, which is equal to, can someone tell me what is the answer? See, our ht is summation ai delta t minus tau I, then I have st. What is the output signal yt? What is the output signal yt? Excuse me?
Sir, ST convolved with ST answer is that Ai S tau I.
Ai S
tau I.
No, it is ST convolved with tau I. Remember, for instance, let's say ST convolved with delta T minus tau I. What is the answer? For instance, let us take a simple question. ST convolved with delta of t minus y, what is the answer?
T minus, ST minus tau I.
Okay, now ST is convolved with summation Ai delta t minus tau I, what is the answer? Okay, very good. It is summation Ai S of T minus tau I. Very good. Thank you. Thank you. So, summation Ai S T minus tau I. Very good. So, we have different delays, different attenuations, is not A1 up to AL minus 1, different delays tau naught tau 1 up to tau L minus 1. So, the net signal will be, as we said, different copies S of t minus tau I attenuated by Ai. Alright, so what we received is different signal copies S t minus tau naught, S t minus tau 1, so on, attenuated by A naught, A1, AL minus 1, and then the sum of this. That is basically what this, if everyone can see, I'm just going to go and interact with some other colleges. This is the net. this is the net signal received. Alright, let me just go and try to interact VCAP. I see a question from VCAP. VCAP, can you hear me? Is there any question? Okay, you try to answer. Okay, thank you. Let me just go to some other college, see if CSPIT DCRU. DCRU, which college is this? DCRU, able to hear me? I think there are some audio problems. BMS, let me go to BMS College of Engineering. BMS, are you able to hear me? BMS, are you able to hear me? BMS College, are you able to hear me? I cannot hear you. Looks like there is an audio problem. GHR College of Engineering. Which college is this? GHRC?
Hello.
Are you able to hear me?
Yes, sir. This is GHRC College of Engineering.
Okay, you're able to hear and follow what I'm saying, right? That is the sum of the received signal. Are you able to follow? So the impulse response is the sum of the impulse responses of these multipath components. That is summation AI delta T minus tau I. And YT is summation AI S T minus tau I. You're able to follow me? Everyone is able to follow me? Okay, very good. So in that case, now what I'm going to do is basically I'm going to now start modeling this in terms of a complex, that is a passband signal. So we know that every signal ST can be represented as, can you see what I'm writing? ST.
Yes, sir.
Equals S baseband T, baseband signal e to the power of j two pi FCT. Can everyone see what I am writing? That this is SBT, which is the complex and this is the carrier, e to the power of j 2 pi FCT is the carrier. This is the FC, is the carrier frequency. FC is the carrier frequency. Is everyone familiar with it? That is, every communication signal, I can represent it in terms of baseband signal multiplied by a carrier. Is that not? Is that correct? That is fine?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
GHR College, that is fine. Now, therefore, ST can be written as baseband signal SBT into e to the power of j 2 pi FCT, where FC, j e to the power of j 2 pi FCT is the carrier. Therefore, corresponding to this signal, now can someone tell me what is the received signal YT? See, we have an expression for YT from the previous slide, what I have written. Can someone tell me what is the expression for YT corresponding to this ST, this modulated signal ST? This is also a modulated signal, right? Because this is baseband signal modulated by carrier. So we can also say this is the modulated.
Sir, it's a summation of that ST with a complex conjugated of that H of P carrier signal with.
Not complex conjugated, convolution, that is what you are saying.
Convolution, yeah, convolutional for that term
Okay, and therefore what is out, and therefore what is the output? We have written it in terms of AI S of t minus tau I, right? Therefore what is the output? Now if you substitute SB or ST in terms of this expression, what will I get? Can someone prompt what will I, what I will get?
Sam, it's a summation of AI with S of t minus tau I into that SB of t e raised to the power j 2 pi FCT.
No, ST is e raised to SBT e raised to j 2 pi FCT. Therefore, I have to substitute this expression what I had previously. What will I get? That is my question. There is answer is clear. So, as previously we had expression for ST. Now, if I substitute this expression for ST, what am I going to get? Can someone prompt me?
With a term of SBT with e raised to j 2 pi FCT, it is commonly added, and attenuation multiplication is with there. AI.
Yeah, tell me the expression, please. Can someone tell me the expression? Can other college, can someone tell me the expression? Okay, TKM college.
Sir, summation I is equal to 0 to L minus 1 AI into SB of
t AI into
SB of t minus AI tau I.
SB of t minus
tau I.
Hang on, let me just write it. SB of t minus tau I times
e raised to j
2
pi
fc
e minus tau I.
E minus tau I. Very good. Thank you. Thank you very much. So what we have now, therefore we have summation AI, because ST is modulated signal SBT into e power j 2 pi FCT. I have AI SBT minus tau I into e to the power of j 2 pi fc t minus tau I. Now therefore here I will simplify this further. I can write this as summation I equals 0. I am getting a hand raise from someone. Let me just go to someone. BTKIT, I think you are coming up with the answer. I already got the answer. I'll just try to interact with you a little bit later. So let me write the answer here. So that is AI SB T minus tau I e to the power of minus j 2 pi FC tau I times e to the power of j 2 pi FCT. That is fine, because e to the power of j 2 pi FCT minus tau I can write as e power j 2 pi FCT into e power minus j 2 pi FC tau I. Is that fine? TKM college, everyone agrees? Yes sir, this is fine. Oh, okay, thank you. So now therefore I can simplify this as yt equals, now e to the power of j 2 pi FCT, that is common to all, right? So I can simplify this as e power j 2 pi FCT into summation I equal to 0 to L minus 1 AI SB T minus tau I e to the power of minus j 2 pi FC Everyone agrees? This is fine? Everyone can see this? I am taking e to the power of j 2 pi fct common to all the terms. Everyone can see? TKM College. Therefore, now this is, you can see this is the carrier. And this is the signal. So this is the carrier. This is now, you can say this is the baseband signal, baseband output signal. Alright, so the baseband signal at the output YBT equals summation I equal to 0 to L minus 1 AI SB T minus tau I e to the power of minus j 2 pi FC tau I. So that is the received baseband signal. TKM College, is that clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay, let me go to some other college, try to start BTKIT. I think they want to. BTKIT, is there a question? I saw a hand raised from you. Is there any question or is everything okay? Everyone able to follow what I'm saying? Everyone able to follow what I'm saying?
Yes, sir.
Okay, thank you. Let me just try to quickly interact with some other college. GIT, let me see if they have... GIT, I think there is some problem. RVC College. PSG College, Coimbatore. PSG College, are you able to follow what I'm saying?
Yes, sir.
PSG College, are you able to follow what I'm saying?
Yes, sir.
Okay, thank you. So now can someone tell me what is the meaning of this? Can someone tell me, see, we have this multipath propagation. We have multipath propagation and with different components, with different delays, tau I of the different multipath components. What is their impact on the baseband? Can you see from this baseband expression that I've written here, what is the impact of the delay tau I? What is the impact of the delay tau I? Can you see what is the impact of the delay tau I? What is, can someone tell me what is the impact of the delay tau I? What is happening because of the delay tau I?
The baseband signal amplified by complex exponentials and it is shifted.
Correct. Very good. And precisely when you say the complex exponential, which are the complex exponential? Can you point out which is the FCT. Very good. Thank you. So what you are seeing is because of the delay, there is a complex phase factor. Correct? Because of the delay tau I, there is a complex phase factor. Now what I am going to do, I am going to employ what is known as the standard narrow band approximation. This is the narrow band approximation. Now, employing the narrow band approximation, I can approximately say SB of T minus tau I, SB of T minus tau I approximately equal to SB of T. This is valid when the maximum frequency FM of the signal of the message is much less than the carrier frequency. Is that valid? Is that clear? So when the message, maximum message frequency, so FM is the FC is the carrier frequency. What I'm saying is, if the maximum frequency FM of the message is much less than FC. For instance, let us take typical values. Let us take a GSM system. What is the carrier frequency? PhD college, can someone tell me what is the carrier frequency in GSM? What is the carrier frequency? What is that? 900 megahertz, approximately 900 megahertz. There are several bands, 900 megahertz is one of the most popular bands. What is the FM, maximum frequency of the message signal? I'm taking a simple example for GSM. For GSM, I'm getting an answer from someone. GSM, let me just GECTN, let me just quickly go to GEC college. Thank you, PhD. Let me just interact with GEC college a little bit. GEC college is not publishing there. GEC college, can you hear me? Can someone hear me? I'm not able to start interaction. Okay, let me try to go to KNMU college. Okay, let me just stay with then PSG college. So okay, GSM, what is the message frequency? Can someone tell me at PSG what is the message frequency of GSM?
40 hertz.
Message frequency. What is the GSM bandwidth? 200 kilohertz signal, bandwidth is 200 kilohertz, but that is baseband, double-sided bandwidth, so it is approximately 100 kilohertz. So GSM message, maximum frequency of the message signal, that is if I look at the baseband signal, that is 100 kilohertz, that is the value of FM. So FM is 100 kilohertz, that is the message bandwidth. Therefore, what we have is this message and 240 kilohertz, correct. GACT and 240 kilohertz, yes, that is the two-sided bandwidth. One-sided bandwidth approximately 120 or basically 100 kilohertz, correct. So therefore, we have 100 kilohertz, that is FM. It's much less than or equal to 900 megahertz, which is the carrier frequency. Therefore, I can say SB P minus tau I approximately equal to SB T. Now, when I have this, if I simplify the previous expression, can you tell me what is, if I use this approximation, what will my YBT become? Can someone tell me? Let me just try to go to a different college. Try to interact with them. VPCOE, I think VPCOE, I can start interaction with them. VPCOE. VPCOE, are you able to see me?
Yes, sir.
If SBT minus, yes, sir, thank you. If SBT minus tau I approximately equals SBT, then what is the YBT? What is the expression for YBT? Baseband signal.
Sir, actually, we are having one question. Hello.
Go ahead.
Sir. Yes, we have started from the one formula. S of t is equal to SBT into e raised to j 2 pi FCT. In that, we have divided that formula into two components. One is complex baseband, that is SBT, and other is carrier. And after that, yes, sir. And after that, we have arrived at one point, that is, we have divided that carrier into two parts.
VP, VPCOE, the volume is a little bit loud. Can you make it a little lower, please? Go ahead, please.
Sir, after that we have divided that carrier into two parts. That is, one is negative and other is positive.
No, there are no two carriers. There is simply e to the power of j 2 pi fct.
No, sir. Yeah, in the equation you have written e raised to minus j. And into e raised to positive, that is j. But in the mathematical form it's okay. But how can we divide the single carrier into two parts? That is my question.
This is not a carrier being divided into two parts. This is the carrier being delayed by tau I. So carrier, when it is delayed by tau I, there will be a phase lag in the carrier. That is what this is saying. See, e to the power of j 2 pi fct, if e to the power of j 2 pi fct is delayed by tau I, there is going to be a phase lag. That phase lag is e to the power of minus j 2 pi fc tau I. And that is what this is. This is e to the power of j 2 pi fct minus tau I, which is nothing but the phase component e to the power of minus j 2 pi fc tau I multiplied by e to the power of j 2 pi fc t. Is that correct? Does that clear your doubt?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now let us say, let us go back to this equation that I have written over here. Now we will substitute SBT minus tau I approximately equals SBT. Can someone tell me what is the answer? TKM, I can see question from them, but let me try to see if I can get from VPCOE if I can get the answer. If I substitute SBT minus tau I approximately equal to SBT, then what is the simplification?
Yes.
What is the expression for YB of T?
It will be summation of AI USBT into e raised to power e by fc tau I.
Okay, thank you. Thank you very much. So it will be summation I equal to 0 L minus 1 AI SB T, because SBT minus tau I approximately equals SBT, e to the power of minus j 2 pi fc tau I. Fine? Thank you, VPCA.
Yes.
Thank you. So now I can take SBT common. So that is nothing but SBT. SBT will come outside common times summation I equal to 0 to L minus 1 AI e to the power of minus j 2 pi FC tau I. So now I can take this whole thing common. So basically what I have is YBT, that is received signal YT, is ST times a complex coefficient. Is that correct, VPCOE? Is that fine?
Yes,
question correct? Yes. And therefore, yes, what I have is YBT is a constant coefficient, approximately it's a constant coefficient times SB of, it's a constant coefficient times SB of T. And therefore, this constant coefficient, so now let me rewrite this again so I can write YBT equals summation I equal to 0 to L minus 1 AI e to the power of minus j 2 pi FC tau I times SB. Is that fine? PCOE, is that fine? So this is basically this constant coefficient times this thing, and this constant coefficient, this is nothing but the fading coefficient. This constant coefficient, this is nothing but the feeding. This is the feeding channel coefficient. Is that okay? VPCOE, everyone can see what I am writing. This is the feeding channel coefficient. Fine?
Yes, sir. And it depends on the, I think, carrier frequency.
It depends on the carrier frequency. That is correct. Doesn't it depend on the carrier frequency? Where is it reflected? Can you point out? Because we have FC here, right?
Yes, sir.
Everyone see that?
FC is there. That is the carrier frequency.
That is the carrier frequency. So it depends on the carrier frequency. Very good. Thank you. Let me just try to go to TKM College. TKM College, do you have a question or is there any question? Oh, any question? No question. Okay, let me just try to interact with someone else. GIT, I have not been able to interact with GIT. GIT College, I can see you now. Can you hear me?
Yes, sir.
GIT College, are you able to follow what I'm writing? That is YBT equals fading coefficient times SB of T, correct?
Yes, sir. We are following what you are saying.
We are following, right? Now, let us take an example. Let us take a simple example. Let us take a case of A naught equal to A1 equal to 1. Tau naught equal to 0, tau 1 or FC tau 1 equals half. Can you tell me what is the value of the fading coefficient corresponding to these values? Corresponding to these values, can GIT College, can you tell me what is the fading coefficient corresponding to A naught equal to A1 equal to 1? So there is a simple question. A naught equal to A1 equal to 1, tau naught equal to 0, FC tau 1 is equal to half. Corresponding to this, what is the value of the fading coefficient? That is L is equal to 2. That is what I am saying. L is equal to 2. From VCAP, I'm getting the answer. Let me just try to see if GIT, if you can come up with answer. Let's walk through the solution. So I will have, for L equal to 2, I will have A naught e power minus j 2 pi fc tau 0, but tau 0 equals 0, so this will be a naught into 1 plus a1 e to the power of minus j 2 pi fc tau 1, but fc tau 1 equals half, so this will be a1 e power minus j 2 pi half, so this is, but a naught equals 1. Go ahead.
Answer is
1
plus e
raised
to minus j pi.
Answer is 1 plus e raised to minus j pi, correct. Very good. Can you simplify it further? What is e raised to minus j pi?
Sir, it is cos pi minus j sin pi and cos pi,
correct.
Minus 1.
Okay. Zero. So what will it become?
1 plus 1 half. Plus cos pi. So 0 is the answer.
Okay, very good. Thank you very much. Very good. So this will be 0. Fine. Now let me change the problem slightly. Let me just go to VCAP, because I also want to interact. Let me just go to VCAP quickly. They also had the answer. V cap, so the answer is 0.
Yes, sir.
Okay, now what happens is Fc tau 1, if Fc tau 1 is equal to 1, what will happen? Fc tau 1, sorry, not Fc tau y, Fc tau 1, if is equal to 1 instead of half, what will happen?
2, sir. 2.
This will be equal to 2. Fading coefficient will be, depending on the value of tau 1, fading coefficient is 0 or fading coefficient is 2. Now, if the fading coefficient is varying, what is happening to the received signal, YP of t?
It's also varying.
Okay, in the first case, what will it be, YB of t?
0.
0. In the second case, it will be?
2.
2. Okay, thank you. Thank you very much. So, you can see clearly what is happening is we have these different multipath components. And these different multipath components are adding with the different phase factors. As someone already pointed out, these are the different phase factors which depend on the carrier frequency. So, this depending on these different phase factors, we can have either constructive interference or destructive interference. Everyone can see that? Can everyone? Okay, I have not been able to unfortunately interact with everyone. Many of them are not able to, I think, connect with the video. So we have either constructive interference or destructive interference. Is that clear? VCAP, is that clear? That depending on the value of tau 1, depending on the values of the DA delays, the interference is constructive or destructive, right? Therefore, the received signal quality is, it is fading. The received signal quality is fading. So this depends, the interference is constructive or destructive, and therefore this received signal quality is fading, and this is known as the fading channel coefficient. This is a fading channel. This is a mathematical model for the fading channel. Why is this a mathematical model? Because precisely depending on the phases, e to the power of minus j 2 pi fct tau I, you have different values of the fading channel coefficient. So this is a model of the fading channel coefficient. It captures the fading phenomena. Alright, so we will stop here. I will take any quick questions if someone has any quick questions, but otherwise I hope it is clear. We have tried to establish a model for the fading channel. From here we will start on with the next lecture. I can see OXCE, I think they have come in slightly. Let me just try to interact with OX. I think this is Oxford College. Oxford College, are you able to hear me, what I am saying? OXE, I can hear you, but I cannot see anyone speaking. So, are you able to follow what my lecture is regarding the fading channel coefficient? Are you able to follow my lecture, OXE? Okay, OXE had some problem. Let me try to see if there is anyone else who I can interact with. BMS College, have you been able to follow my lecture? Okay, let me interact with one last college, VPCOE, TKM, SGG, SIET. Unfortunately, I could not interact with them today. SGG, SIET? Oh, RVIT, let me interact with RVIT. RVIT, are you able to follow my lecture? Have you been able to follow it?
Yes, sir.
You're able to understand it? Okay, very good. Let me just try to go to KNMU. KNMU, I am not able to get it. KNMU, please respond by chat if you have been able to follow it or if there are any questions. GCT, okay, GCT, DCRU. DCRU, have you been able to follow the lecture? Okay, I will stop here. I think there are some audio issues I'm seeing from some colleges, and some colleges have not been able to establish video interaction. So I hope everyone is able to follow the lecture. Basically what we have been able to do is we have developed a model of the fading wireless channel, and then we will start from here in the next lecture. Thank you. Thank you very much.